Welcome to That's Pretty Neat with Rodger and Stefan, where we discuss neat, holistic, regenerative agriculture.
So what's special about these cows?
Well, what's special about these neats is that they are the particular breed being Bonsmaras come out of Africa, and they naturally stay together as a pretty tight herd. As you can see here, they've come out of the mountains as a herd, obviously because you're enticing them, but they're quite happy to stay as a herd.
Yep.
They feel safer as a herd. Quite a nice image here of all the calves being shepherded by a couple of old ladies, making sure everyone comes along and the herd stays together.
Yeah. What are some cool things about Bonsmara as the breed that you think makes them fit for our ranch?
Well, if we can see some of them from side on, you'll actually see the dewlap that they have. If you look at number 9060, they have a dewlap in front of their neck. And if it's an eland in Africa, which is the largest antelope in the world, the eland has a big dewlap. And if you look at any of the plains game where it's really hot, that have dewlaps, they use it for cooling themselves. So if you look at the Bonsmara, they all have a dewlap. So California, hot weather, Texas, New Mexico, Colorado, all of the Southern American hot climates, that dewlap is really useful for regulating temperature. And the other thing, if we get up close and look at them closely, you'll see that they have a Roman nose.
A Roman nose.
Yeah, so their nose bows outwards. And that Roman nose, basically there's more airflow cooling the blood that goes into the nose. So they've got the Roman nose to stay cool and the dewlap to stay cool, which definitely makes them different to all the breeds that came out of Europe and England.
Yes.
The Black Angus and...
they tossed the pack, so...
The Black Angus most of the European breeds have a dish face, and they're designed to stay warm in cold weather. These guys are designed to stay cool in hot weather.
Yeah.
However, if you look at these young calves, they're pretty woolly.
Yeah.
Well, that's because the Bonsmara breed combined the African features with the European features. So Bonsmara is a composite, scientifically bred animal that is utilizing the Afrikaner as the main seed stock, but then they cross them with Shorthorn and Hereford. Or as they say in England, Hereford. So you've got kind of the best of both worlds. You've got animals that can take the heat or the cold, Texas A&M did a study on the meat, and they said it's the most tender meat they found in America.
In America?
In America. Wow. So it's a tender meat. The animals are habitat dependent. And as you can see, well, as you know for yourself, you selected this breed because of your mountainous terrain.
Yeah.
And these guys are quite happy going up and down,
mm-hmm.
and they're quite happy browsing or grazing.
What else makes them special?
One of the really nice things about Bonsmara, and I presume you've had the same experience, is it's a very small calf.
Yeah.
On average, I think your calves probably weighed about 76 pounds.
76 pounds.
76 pounds, and they grow very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the scientific breeding. They designed a cow that would have ease of calving because it throws a small baby, but that grows fast. And that is what you as a Bonsmara breeder do, is you keep your records very accurately so that you can select for the ones that have the highest performance and make sure that the performance standards of the breed are maintained. Mm-hmm. So, you know, if you look at the majority of these calves here, what I think your biggest ones are 7 or 8 months old.
Yeah.
Really. So they've grown to the regular size. And one of the major problems that Americans who are new to Bonsmara have had is that they overfed their animals because they weren't used to such small animals that were so efficient on poor feed. Hmm. And they ended up having their udders blow out because they overfed them, mm-hmm. or gave them diets that were too rich because they were used to the American cattle that you've just got to pump groceries into them. Otherwise, they do poorly, whereas these ones do poorly if you pump groceries into them.
Yeah.
So, but I mean, look at this little guy. He's looking quite good. And,
yeah, he is. Yeah.
So, these are neat beats.
I think so too. Mm-hmm. What's your favorite Bonsmara quality? Favorite one?
The herd.
The herd effect.
The fact that they stay together naturally as a herd. I didn't realize just how much they herded until I visited them on a ranch in Texas. And there were 15 cattle in a paddock and there were 640 acres and all 15 cattle were stuck to each other. Mm. Whereas any Black Angus herd, there would have been 15 cattle spread over the whole square mile. And that was the first time I realized, oh, this instinct has crossed the ocean with them.
Yeah.
So when you lose your herd, you lose your whole herd. And when you find your herd, you find your whole herd.
Yeah.
So we've got meat quality, we've got temperature, we've got small calves, we've got tender beef. And it's a non-fatty meat. Hmm. So it's a nice lean meat. And because you're grass finishing your animals and doing everything correctly, the quality of the product you're going to be producing and the quality of the bulls that you're going to be producing is great. The fact that you went around America and selected the 100 best heifers you could find means that the genetic foundation for any bulls that you produce is going to be second to none. You've done a better job than any other breeder in America. So I expect in 3 to 5 years when these little guys are big and looking like their dad, I think you're going to have some really nice bulls here.
They're awful cute, aren't they?
They're awful cute. What's been your impression of having the breed?
When we first got the first 20, they were very packed together and very not fond of people. But although it was kind of tough to get used to it, we calmed them down and they kept a lot of that really cool quality of sticking together with them. So now we kind of have a herd that we can call. So at first we weren't very happy about the fact that they stuck together, even though we knew we needed it. Mm-hmm. But we found that once they got more comfortable with us, it became a big benefit to have within the genetics instinct of the herd.
Okay. I love that sound of cows grazing.
It's pretty neat.
It's a neat sound. Yep.
You can follow Roger at d2gftf.com and also on his socials at Roger Savory Holistic Management on YouTube and Facebook. We are Las Cumbres Ranch. You can follow us on social media at Las Cumbres Ranch over all platforms. And thanks for tuning in. It's been real neat.